Welcome to this video on measuring differential expression using RNA-seq data with Geneious Prime. To begin, you must map the different sets of reads to a reference sequence. I have two sets of RNA-seq reads in this example, each from a different experimental condition. I also have a reference sequence. Select the reads and the reference files. Then go to Align, Assemble, and Map to Reference. Ensure you correctly specify your reference sequence at the top. You can use the drop-down menu to identify a different file in the same folder, or select Choose to select a file in another Geneious folder. If you're assembling more than one set of reads, like in this example, you can assemble each file separately by selecting this option. In the Method section, specify the mapper used in the analysis. There are numerous mappers available in Geneious, each with its pros and cons. Learn more about them by selecting the Help button. For this example, I will leave these settings as default. In the bottom left of the window, you can specify what level of trimming to apply before mapping. For this example, I will use existing trim regions. Lastly, in the bottom right, you can adjust what results should be returned from the mapping. When you're happy with the settings, click OK to run the assemblies. The result is an assembly report summarizing the mapping and individual assembly files. Next, use the assembly files to calculate the expression levels of the different genes in each file. To do this, select an assembly file, go to Annotate and Predict, and choose Calculate Expression Levels. In the new window, specify how to treat ambiguously mapped reads and the annotation type of interest, and click OK. You should now see a new track created on the reference in the assembly file. Click Save to save your changes, and when prompted, choose to apply the changes to the original sequence. Because my two assemblies represent different experimental sample conditions, I need to run the Calculate Expression Levels analysis separately for the other sample. If you select both assemblies and run the analysis on both at once, Geneious will assume that these are a single sample and your calculations will be incorrect. However, if you have multiple reference sequences for each sample, such as one set of reads mapped to multiple chromosomes, then all contigs from that sample should be selected and run in a single step. Once you have saved these results, you should see different expression annotation tracks, one for each sample, loaded on the reference sequence. If you cannot see them, check that you have tracks enabled in the Annotations and Tracks tab. To find differentially expressed genes between the two sample conditions, go to Annotate and Predict and Compare Expression Levels. In the new window, use the drop-down menus to specify the newly created tracks containing the expression level. You can then set what to compare. Transcripts, in this case, are recommended. Also, specify how to normalize the data. Usually, this is the median of gene expression ratios. Then click OK. Ensure you save the file. Geneious will add a new track to the reference sequence. If you mouse scroll over a gene, the pop-up will display data, including the raw read and transcript counts for each sample condition, plus a list of differential expression scores such as the p-value. The differential expression p-value indicates whether the differential expression observed is statistically significant. The color of the genes on the track displays the differential expression confidence value. Geneious uses this value to color the annotations in sample 2 compared to sample 1. The colors range from blue for underexpressed genes, white for genes that are not differentially expressed, and red for overexpressed genes. To filter the results, for example, showing only those genes significantly overexpressed in sample 2 compared to sample 1, select the down arrow next to the Filters option in the Annotations and Tracks view. Change the field to Differential Expression Confidence. Then adjust the values to greater than 2. This equates to a p-value of less than 0.01. So, the track will only show genes that are significantly overexpressed in sample condition 2 than in sample condition 1 at p less than 0.01. Switch to the Annotations tab to view the differential expression results in tabular format and view the differential expression track data only. Use the Columns drop-down menu to select data of interest, including the differential expression confidence. You can also export the results in CSV format by selecting Export Table. By switching to the next tab, you can view the volcano plot. This scatter plot displays the gene fold changes on the x-axis and the absolute confidence levels on the y-axis. By selecting the advanced option, you can also show vertical and horizontal lines at your desired level, and even color points that are beyond these thresholds. And that's how you measure differential expression in Geneious Prime. To learn more, visit Geneious.com.